Hey everybody, this is Nick Mayhew, three-time gold medalist and three-time world record holder, and you're listening to Power 98.5.
We don't play the social game. We are social. Power 98.5. You're listening to Power 98.5, powered by United Angels Dream, your number one resource for public relations, entertainment, and multimedia. Contact them today at unitedangelsdream.com.
Hi, this is Dan Aykroyd. He's progressive. He's beautiful. He's thoughtful. He's intelligent. He's powerful. He's positive. He is Steven Cuoco on Power 98.5 Satellite Radio.
Empowering listeners from the US to the UK. Live on air with Steven Cuoco.
We've got another gorgeous, and I mean gorgeous, day here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I am Steven Cuoco, and you are live on air with Steven Cuoco on Power 98.5 Satellite Radio. Headed out of Manchester, UK, New York, and now Las Vegas, Nevada. We are headlining anywhere and everywhere where everyone is to be. Vegas is the spot. Everything's reopening up. No more mask mandate. What else? Pools are starting. Day clubs are opening up. Clubs are packed again. And I'm doing a 5 mile run for charity on May 1st. So, with now that you're all caught up, we've covered a lot, especially after four time gold medalist Ryan Murphy. Boy, was that interview a major, major hit. And those who tune in on the iOS Android app, Alexa, and power985.com. Today, we have an incredible young artist, 18. Shocked to find that out because he's very seasoned, very mature. We've got RYMAN in the house. He's a singer, songwriter, the namesake of one of the most revered venues in his hometown of Nashville, and is poised to impact this year with his uniquely youthful and colorful sound. A musician by nature, RYMAN remembers being drawn to music as early as preschool, stating, "I've been coming up with melodies ever since I can remember. Literally, at the age of 3 years old, I was humming or singing lyrics and not knowing where they came from. Now, with a thoughtful grasp of his musical subsidies, sensibilities, RYMAN's melodies and lyrics are very much backed by intention and purpose. He has a new hit single, which we're going to play live, titled Sober. So, welcome to the show, RYMAN.
What's going on? Thanks so much for having me.
It is an honor. It was great to have obtained the information from Sarah, your representative. And we could not help but not put this track, Sober, on the playlist on Power 98.5. How do you feel? Like, do you often get support from radio stations?
I think this is the first that I know of.
On record.
So I feel great. to my knowledge, yes.
Well, you know, here's the thing, and you and I had a conversation a little bit before we went live. The whole purpose to do what we ought to do is to support you and musicians like yourself. You create these incredible tracks. Your videos are outstanding. Your performances are top notch. You know, you've got your Gen Z. Your generation is really creating and enveloping a way of entrepreneurship, which I know that word, RYMAN, is so used most often, but really it is just the identification of independence, if you want to put it like that way. It's impressive.
Yeah, it's so awesome.
So where did it begin for you?
For me, I would say I've always grown up like in a musical household. And I actually got grounded whenever I was in the seventh grade. And I got my video games taken away and technology. And we've had a piano at the house. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to figure out how to play piano today because I'd already been singing and making instrumentals and stuff on my dad's laptop in GarageBand. But I just decided to learn how to play piano, and that spewed into me writing songs and singing and recording them.
What's interesting is I was told your dad played the Beatles and Bob Dylan, which I grew up with those two music artists as well. But what's also very interesting is your mom played everything from indie to rap to classic rock. How did that mesh together growing up?
Well, I think it really, for me, like it's translated into what I listen to now, is that I don't listen to like one specific genre of music all the time. And I think that also helps me not to create just like a formulated, boring pieces of work all the time and the exact same sounding stuff. I think it's important to have a coherence, but at the same time, you don't want to stay in one singular path the entire time.
How would you describe yourself as a musician or music artist?
I would say that, like, especially like with my songs, I think vulnerability is a big thing. And I don't like try to do like overcomplicated with what I say most of the time. It's pretty straightforward, but I think that that's what really resonates with people the best. Cause I like it whenever like I hear a song personally and it speaks to me. And I don't have to put like a ton of thought. Like, I think that, like, yes, like metaphors and like crazy complicated lyrics are super cool. But for me personally, at least, I really like the straightforwardness and heaviness of like some of my own lyrics.
We're going to take a couple steps back to the, you know, the most recent track that you made titled Immature. You had referenced that, it basically talks about breaking a girl's heart, but learning from your mistakes and wanting her back. How true is that to your own personal experience? Are you writing? Did you create this song, Immature, because of your own personal experience from what I just said?
Or what I read? That one specifically, I wrote the chorus of it months before I actually finished the entire song. And it had a completely different feel to it. But that song specifically was not from like a personal experience.
But not from a personal experience. Well, then yeah, no. Your heart's saved. You didn't get your heart broken yet. And we don't want you to either.
I don't know about that, but I have some other ones that are very real.
So you've come out with, you've got Space, Pushover, Immature, and now Sober. What makes Sober so unique from the other three?
I think the production is very guitar driven. And that same thing with the Immature and my music in the past, it hasn't really been very guitar driven. And that's always because guitar isn't like my main instrument, but I've been trying to think as much outside of the box. And like I said earlier, stray away from one specific sound the entire time. And so it's been really fun getting to kind of think outside the box and experiment with different sounds and ideas.
The video is very well done. What or how much, Ryman, did you put into the directorial of this? Did you sit down with a team, have a storyboard, let them know exactly what was going on in your head, what you felt emotionally, immensely before creating this? Or where did this sit with you in a storyline?
Well, so funny story. My next door neighbor it's been like my childhood best friend, has always been into film work and stuff like that. And he had never done a music video before, and I had a small amount left in a budget for a previous project for Space, and I was like asking my label if it'd be okay if I just did like a homemade music video with my best friend, and they ended up loving it so much that they've booked him to do my Immature video that he did, and then they also did booked him to do the Sober video, and that idea was completely him. Like I I did throw in like some suggestions and stuff, but overall, that was his idea for the video and his vision, and it was perfectly executed too.
We're gonna play it now, Sober by RYMAN.
When did you turn into a stranger? Only thing familiar is that t-shirt. I know it's always been your favorite. When did things start changing? I'm misbehaving. When you said you're leaving tonight, I wasn't even surprised. Been getting used to the space in my head, in my bed. You used to light me on fire. I got so used to the high. I smoked you every night.
You know, this track really in combination with the video, RYMAN, it has an American Pie vibe to it.
Thank you so much.
Did anyone ever tell you that?
No, they did not.
I literally see like The Hangover, Being Here in Vegas, No BS, and American Pie. Have you ever thought of thinking of down the road collabing with Steve Aoki, Tiesto, Zedd? Because there's like, I can just see or foresee future collaborations with you and major, major top DJs out there.
I've always wanted to do, that's actually funny you say that. I've been talking to my producer, Cleve, about how much I want to do a song with some kind of drop or like a DJ type song. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think that'd be great.
Could that be a project that you could end up accomplishing in 2022?
I totally believe that that could be possible. Yeah.
And then we've got to have it here playing either at Omnia or like, seriously, you're
that'd be crazy.
Your craft and your brilliance is perfect for the Vegas market. It's just, you're very much ahead of your time. I don't know if anyone's ever told you that before or not, but you are absolutely brilliant. Please let Mason know that I'm super impressed by the video, the vibe, very American Pie, very much like The Hangover. You've got great things, many, many great things to look forward to. And I say this as a compliment. You remind me slightly of a clean-cut version of a Post Malone.
I'm flattered. Thank you.
So just know that you can cross-reference yourself and your gift and your talent in any genre, and especially with the fact that, you know, you grew up with a mom and dad that had really good taste in music, and this is a result. And you've established your own narrative in your own context, and you're living in your truth and expressing it in the best way possible.
I really appreciate that.
any closing thoughts at all, Ryman? And who would you like to give a shout out to?
I would say definitely shout out my team over at Cinematic for everything they do. That's my label. My producer, Cleve, all the writers involved with Sober, especially Blake Ruby and Mason as well.
And
none of this would be possible without any of those guys.
No, and that's what you said it perfectly. It takes a very good team. And most importantly, your team has proven that they are passionate about you and your music and what you're doing. And it comes through very, very clear.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I think it's very necessary. I think a lot of times it can be an ego thing for some people wanting to do everything themselves. Mm-hmm. But really is super beneficial to have multiple minds brainstorming on a project.
And are you going to pursue college or university at all, or is this full time for you now, music?
Yeah, it's kind of a scary thought since I'm about to graduate here in like a month. But yeah, I don't think I'm going to be doing the college route. I think I'm just going to try to pursue this full time.
Well, definitely. You deserve it. Ryman, what are the best plug-in go-to for social media? Is it TikTok, Instagram? Where are you at the most?
I'd say Instagram I'm probably the most active on. But TikTok is definitely the best platform to try to reach a new audience just because of how their For You page algorithm works. Instagram is not really the same. It's kind of harder to gain followers on Instagram. But if you are making music or have some kind of art, definitely need to be on TikTok.
And your website?
Yeah.
Do you have one?
I do. RymanWooten.com.
Say that again one more time.
RymanWooten.com.
How do you spell that last part?
W-O-O-T-E-N.
I like that. And
it's Ryman, my last name.
Is your last name. And Ryman, R-Y-M-A-N. So yep. All things Ryman, go to his YouTube page, R-Y-M-A-N. Interact, like, comment, you know, take a listen to, you know, Sober, which we're playing right now, streams live 24/7 on Power 98.5 satellite radio. He's got Immature, Pushover, and Space. And I'm looking forward to, you know, having you back on again, doing another live music drop. And if there's any other tracks that you would like to push, whether it be Immature, Pushover, or Space, we can have you back on. If you're going to do any collaborations with any DJs or something, you know, definitely I can just see Tiesto, Steve Aoki, maybe even a Chainsmokers. You would just fit well with any one of them.
For sure. I'd love to come back on here.
Anytime, my friend. So hold the line. We're closing out with Sober by Ryman. And, you know, I don't need to say any more. All you have to do is just go on Google. Just type in R-Y-M-A-N.
Yeah.
us on your socials and let's connect.